Codsworth.
Shall I accompany you, sir?
Apparently, the castle's been trying to get you on the radio. Some kind of situation over there.
Thank you. finally. I've been waiting to talk to you.
You forgot to make an appointment.
Ah, what smart mouth, eh? I'm Ronnie Shaw, Commonwealth Minutemen. At least I was. Back before Joe Becker got himself killed and the idiots took over.
I don't like what you're implying.
Easy there, cowboy. Joe Becker died years before you came along. I'm talking about the gang of clowns that let the Minutemen fall apart. I didn't respect any of them, so I took a vacation.
I'd still like to hear what you came to talk to me about.
Heard you were trying to get the Minutemen back on their feet. Thought I'd come see the new general for myself. So what's your story? What makes you think anybody even wants the Minutemen back?
At least we're trying to help people. Can you say the same?
Don't give me any attitude, Sonny. I've been a Minuteman longer than you've been alive. But I've heard some good things about what you've been doing. Wouldn't be here otherwise. Now that I'm here, I can see you really need my help.
We can always use more experienced soldiers.
Yeah, you're not kidding. But I had something more specific in mind. I'm probably the only one who still remembers this. But the castle's armory was located in the West Bastion. All of our best equipment was stored in there. Weapons, ammo, schematics, you name it. Come on, I'll show you. Still be intact. Door still sealed. Bastion hasn't collapsed. Trick now is finding a way in.
I hope you have an idea.
Of course I do. If you can't go through, go around. Let's have a look at the northeast bastion. General's quarters. Used to be a tunnel leading from here to the armory. This tunnel's blocked by this rubble. We'll have to find some way to clear it.
Good morning, Commonwealth. This is Radio Freedom, the voice of the Minutemen. This just in. The settlement has requested help from the Minutemen. Let's not leave them hanging, people.
and ever get to stop. Let's get this over with. United we stand. Yeah, that was it. Ah, that explains all the landmines. This is, well, was, General McGann. He had your job back when I first joined him. Must have gotten trapped down here when that sea beast attacked the castle. He did manage to keep the armory secure. I'll give him that much. Guess the uniform is yours now, if you want it. So the geezer doesn't need it anymore. Rest in peace, General. Fight.
Quiet, which is how we like it. Stay safe out there. to admit, Ronnie, having artillery would help out quite a bit.
Oh, we used to rain down fire on Deathclaws and super mutants alike. It was a glorious thing. Looks like you've got everything we need. As soon as you get some artillery built, we'll do a test fire to calibrate it.
Just looking to trade a little.
We've got to get the transmitter powered back up before I can get back to broadcasting.
Darn, it's good to see artillery here again. But here's the thing about the big guns. They can't fire at anything too close. Their range is impressive. That's what the smoke grenades are for. Toss one of those at the bad guys. If we have artillery in range, we'll confirm over the radio and target our fire on your smoke. But first, we better do a test fire. Make sure we're hitting what we're aiming at. You see that little building over there? We'll use that for our aiming point. Keep your radio on and tuned to Radio Freedom so we can confirm we're ready.
All right, General, if you can hear me, we're ready. Cause one of those smoke grenades into the turret.
can.
Thank you.
Strong.
Go find milk of human kindness with Strong.
Don't you No need to hide. All over soon.